I would now like to invite our chairman to share with you the nuances of life. Sir, please.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon to all of you. So how well are you feeling here? Are you feeling comfortable with us? How do you like VIPS? Is that a good institution? What kind of hopes do you have from an institution of this repute? Because seventh rank, who is the seventh rank here? There's a lady sitting here. And you hail from Shalimar Bagh, isn't that? And she is the person who chose VIPS as a priority. Rank 7 picked up VIPS. Rank 7 picked up University School of Law and Legal Studies. And rank 46 picked up the so-called MIT Law School. Understand? So she chose the right school because there's no publicity hype, no publicity blitzkrieg, no television ads or any newspaper ads. We simply keep working and incessantly working and shaping you as lawyers. Just now you heard a speech. It was not a speech, in fact. It was a narration of one's life story. How the judicial process unfolds itself to the newcomers. How much courage you should have, courage of conviction. It has nothing to do with politics, it has nothing to do with somebody's allegiance to any other party. Here we played this clip only in the context of law and only in the context of budding lawyers, which all of you are going to be. The lawyer has to have tremendous patience at one's command. As he was rightly saying, you have to read the whole brief back to back. And when you have read the brief, you should be so well prepared when you go to the court that not only you should know much more than what the opposite counsel knows, but you should also know what more than the judges also know. Then only you win the case. So this video clip was played only in the context of application of law, because he himself was 26 years, and the person who was going against an election petition under the People's Representative Act, he was also moneyless, he had no money. And this house suggests here that don't worry, even if the client doesn't have money, he can earn you goodwill as a good lawyer. That goodwill is worth billions of dollars or rupees. You can't buy a goodwill. He or she is a good lawyer. Is the lawyer standing? Is the lawyer of repute? You become good lawyers. What is repeatedly said was by updating your knowledge, by being vociferous readers, very keen readers, because you should know each and everything about a case. Back to back, you should know. Familiarize yourself with the facts. Read them in the context of law. When the law, in the application of law comes, you should know how to project the case, how to portray the case. Presentation is a very major thing in law. How you make a presentation, how you present before the Honorable Court is called court craft. How well drafted is your petition shows your ability to present your point of view. And many of those judgments written earlier by many Honorable Judges of the High Court and Supreme Court, they have a touch of literature. So what you need to do is to be keen readers always. Not necessarily that you should read only law books, but you can also read literature. A lot of reading material you should have on your bedside and on your study table. So you need to read and read, minimum 3 to 4 hours of self-study is required from an average lawyer. If you want to be an extraordinary lawyer, you must study 4 to 5 hours. Regularly you should study. I am just dropping you hints. The man whose video clip was being played here, can you imagine what could be his appearance? How much does his appearance cost in the Supreme Court? How much is the appearance? I mean, can you guess? Can you lay a rough estimate to me? And can you tell me how much he should be charging for one appearance?
10 lakhs.
She's approximately right, but anything between 15 to 20 lakhs a hearing. And that too, everyone doesn't get the time to have a conference with him. You need to prefix the appointment, seek an appointment, go to him, and then he will give you patient hearing and study the whole case page-wise, and then after skipping through the facts of the case, then he will commit himself, yes, I'll appear. Appearance cost 15 to 20 lakhs, and he has minimum 7 to 8 cases a day on an average for which he appears. So what's his daily income? So is also his contemporary and the present Honorable Finance Minister, Mr. Arun Jaitley, another senior advocate. They are not dependent on bribes or corrupt money. They are self-sufficient. He has declared his assets. He has nothing to fear about. He is a fearless man. The first one to reveal one's assets, what Mr. Arun Jaitley said, I have no moral right to be in politics and yet be corrupt. His integrity is above board. That's why he can say demonetization or GST or economic reforms. He has the courage of conviction and he says, I don't need to fear anybody. I don't need to fear the income tax rates because I've made everything transparent. Every penny is accountable. I accounted for money. The chartered accountants have put up before the income tax commissioners and the authorities, and I've been completely declared a clear, you know, holding an asset of about to the tune of 80 crores. But all this money came from legal practice. So what kind of legal practitioner you want to be? Did you ever have the chance to go to the library? On either side of the law library, there are quotations from Justice Chandrachud to M.C. Sitalwar to Justice Mukherjee to Ambedkar and those who are lawmakers, you know. Right from lawmakers to the jurists. I mean, in jurists, there are quotations on either side of the library. If you go there, in the corridors, on either side of the library, there are quotations, you know. Get inspiration from them. Become legendary figures. Don't become ordinary lawyers. Supporting a black robe and being run-of-the-mill lawyer and going to Tehsildari courts and to Rohini courts and rubbing shoulders with all and sundry. It all depends on each one of you as to what kind of lawyers you want to be. A man at the age of 26 could challenge the Supreme Court judges, your judgment is wrong. Because he has studied the law so well, he knew all about the law, he had read all the relevant law books, he had referred to minimum 20, 30, 40 law books which he carries himself with him in a trolley. If you have ever visited the Supreme Court, there's a trolley that goes, which carries loads and loads of law books, and which is, each one of them is flagged by the junior lawyers. And they do their homework well. It's a very well researched case when they argue in the Supreme Court. So the judge advocate general, the judge on record of the Supreme Court, we have 6 or 7 of those who have qualified as advocates on record of the Supreme Court. You know what does it cost at being advocate on record? First to do your 5 years law, Then you complete your 4 years of minimum 4 years of legal practice. Then you do your apprenticeship under one of the advocates on record for 1 year. That's the minimum 5 years, another 5 years. You can attempt that examination. And you know how tough is the examination? How tough it is to qualify to be an advocate on record of the Supreme Court? You are given 75 constitutional judgments. And from there, you need to attempt the paper, question paper. If you are right, you will be selected on merit. And once you become an advocate on record of the Supreme Court, you know what does it mean? No brief can be settled without having to go through the office of the advocate on record. So simply for filing, you make money because you are the only advocate on record. So all the advocates, arguing advocates, should be flocking to your office and say, please file my case, please file my case. For filing itself, it'll run into lakhs of rupees a month income. Four of our students have also become judge, advocate, general in the army. They chose army, they straight got selected as a lieutenant, and one of the lady's father was talking to me. He said, she wants to go to the infantry. She doesn't want to be judge, advocate, general. A judge, advocate, general's job is not in the field, but to be a part of the court martial proceedings. But she says, no, Papa, I'm not content with my job. I don't want to do a sitting job in an office. I want to go to the border and an actual line of control and have the gun in my hand and counter the army. Look at the spirit of this young lady. Have this kind of zeal, this spirit, a persuasive spirit. So you have a huge challenge in front of you. It's not just like attending classes, going around the cafeteria, whiling away your time in gossiping, and having good parties and fun and everything. You have had enough, I think, by 10 plus 2, each one of you have exhausted all those entertainment channels. Must have seen all the movies almost up to date. Must have visited every PVR in the city. Everything is good. But the end of it, what boils down to is, what are you worth? Your worth is going to be evaluated after you end up completing your 5 years law. What you end up, you have been thriving on your parents' money, hard-earned money. They get you branded clothes, branded watches, anything that you ask for. Your parents come forward and say, my child should be happy. It's not a lasting happiness. Remember the one thing. If you want to really make your parents feel proud, you say, today I am earning, and I am the one who is going to spend on you buying branded things, Papa or Mama. When shall that day come? When you will stand, when you will be self-reliant. When you will be self-reliant, self-supporting, economically independent, and say, here I am, I'm an advocate and I've got a good practice, and my parents, I don't want to be a burden on you. Can you make this happen? You have an opportunity by getting into law. You can earn huge sum of money. Some of you can turn to be philanthropists also. Maybe your earnings are too much and you can spare some of your money for a good job, for the welfare of the society. This particular profession offers you an opportunity to earn and to spend and to invest in social welfare activities. No other profession ever since the freedom struggle. Go down the ages, 70 years, 75 years prior to that, most of the freedom struggle was spearheaded by eminent advocates, jurists and judges. They were the leaders because they knew the application of law. They could argue out their case They could logically talk to the British, listen, you can't hold on to our territory for a long time. We are now educated people. We are an enlightened society. We can take care of ourselves. And that's how the British people came around and thought, no, India has sufficient wisdom to run its own rule. They can rule themselves. They can have their own governance. They are capable people. So from that India of 70 years, and now India is technologically advanced. Talk of any science. We have widened our horizons. We have deepened our knowledge. We have prospered. And we have prospered because each time we rose to the occasion. If a scientist was wanted, people came forward to say, I'll work in the DRDO, the Defense Research Development Organization. Some people came forward, I want to work for the space science. Some people came forward, I want to be a good advocate and contribute to the intellectual treasury of this nation. Lawyers have always made a world of difference in the quality of life of a society. The cases are being argued for free. Senior advocates are volunteering themselves. They say, we have enough money, now I want to do something for the society, for the nation. And what happens? They appeal to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court alone can make statute, can change the statute also. They can interpret the law better. They are the apex court. But before that is a legislature. A responsive and a responsible legislature. May that be parliament or state legislatures, the enactment of law takes place there. So you take care of sociological, you know, sociology, because sociology is being taught to you. What customs? I mean, it's your customs that determine what kind of law need to be drafted. What kind of law you need? The society will determine that. The societal customs will do that. Your tradition will shape the law. And then will come the historical background as to why, when Manusmriti started and how is the legal history has progressed and how has it been codified now. Once upon a time, when the headman of the village said, there's no need for anything, we don't need courts, we don't need the law books as well, because we will use our own wisdom to settle the case or to do the arbitration at the village level. The headman of the village was the judge then. Simple people, innocent people, no wickedness, the virtuous people, men of great integrity, men of great values, and they said there's no need for lawyers to be there because lawyers will bring more problems here. Yes, lawyers introduce more problems, make things more complicated. If you are chronic litigants, I mean, God save us. God save the society, because most of you become perverted, perverted lawyers, and you put an RTI or you put some kind of illicit information, then try to resort to blackmailing tactics. So there are good lawyers and bad lawyers, but please don't become bad lawyers. Bad lawyers are no more required. Their lifespan does not last more than 5 years. In 5 to 6 years, you get exposed. You are in the shaping of a good lawyer or a bad lawyer. And remember, anyone who does not stay informed will be out. You need to stay always informed. Anybody who is formless, may that be a sportsperson, doctor or a lawyer, if you are not in touch with the knowledge, if you are not in touch with the divine, if you are not in touch with the live wire, remember, you will become out of form. Such sportsperson was doing well up till a certain period. Now Rahul Dravid has become redundant in Indian cricket. Saurav Ganguly also has become redundant now. Nobody remembers Saurav Ganguly. At that time, yes, we used to appreciate and applaud and say, oh, he's doing a wonderful job, he's a good batsman. Such person is a good bowler. You are known by your accomplishments. You are known by what you achieve. It's not known by your being a liability on this planet. Don't become a liability on this planet. This planet is already very overburdened. That's why environment law came into being. We have to maintain ecological balance. We have to have the anti-dumping laws. And China is dumping its nuclear waste here in the Indian Ocean. So there's endless laws, but nothing to control Delhi's pollution, because each one of us is responsible. When I see in the morning, it's difficult to get inside the college, but because there are too many cars, the cars outnumber the number of people out here. Each one of us has a car. It's a status symbol. Please don't have this tag of status symbol. It's disastrous. It will destroy your true self. You will never ever be able to develop. But because you have learned to be dependent and not to be independent. Please come out and be in form always. And when I say be informed, means remain informed. You should be a well-informed citizen. Very well-informed person, very well-educated, and then shall come the enlightenment that what I am heading towards is, you'll be able to find out and reason it out with yourself whether what the time that I spent in the college was worth or not. We want to make your time worthy of being here for 5 years, because by that time we would have imparted you the legal skills which will bar excellence, which will be unparalleled, I tell you. The way we have the best of faculty members here, they want to make you into good lawyers. We don't want to put a tag of bad lawyer on you. We don't want you to disappoint your clients. We want you to instill hope in them and say, here I am, I'll defend you. You have been wrongly implicated. You have to become a ray of hope and not disappointment. So you yourself can do all this, and the people sitting in the last row, two of these three boys, they are gossiping even now. This is what will ruin your career. I'll not lose anything. You can indulge in gossiping. But remember this, what I'm telling you is going to be relevant in your life. I'm telling you in your life's context. If you think you can take life casually, it's your choice. If you think that what I'm saying matters to you or makes a difference in your lives, listen to me. If you don't want to listen to me, you can always raise your hands and say, hey, you're speaking utterly nonsense. We don't want to hear it. Do that outside if you want to. But once you have committed yourself to the privileges of this institute, you have been admitted. You have been admitted to the privileges of this institute. Having been admitted to the privileges of this institute, you need to remain in such particular discipline. Even in the courts, you need to call the presiding judge as lordship. Even if he or she is junior to you, even a batch junior to you, you are a senior person and having graduated with bright, with a bright prospects, doesn't matter. The person who is sitting on the higher pedestal and is presiding, is the presiding officer of the court, you need to address him or her as a lordship. Why? Because these attributes of being just, being truthful, being honest, they are the virtual divine attributes which manifest themselves. These very attributes can only manifest through a person who has a true heart, a kind heart, a simple-hearted person, and who wants to be very factual, is not a prejudiced mind, doesn't really get influenced by your oratory, but get influenced by what law says. So if you want to be judges, be lordships, it's up to you. If you just want to be one of those pleaders, poor pleaders, lordship, no, my contention was this, then you are pitying yourself. At the end of 5 years, when you go out, I'll appeal to my faculty members to give you the legal drafting skills. I don't want you to go raw there and get, you know, blindfolded and say, we don't know anything of law. We read law 5 years back and now we don't know anything of law. Your attention power should be good. You should listen to every lecture with rapt attention, go home, refresh it. Update your knowledge, go to different sources of law, refer different law books. Next day you come at least for 4 or 5 questions, or at least 2 questions to be asked from your teacher as to why can't this law be interpreted like this. Let it be interactive, let it not become a mono-dialogue. So what I suggest to you, that we have found people pass out law, they have donned the black apron, they go there, and what happens? He or she doesn't know anything about law. When you go out of this, or the portals of this institute, you should be fully equipped with the legal knowledge. Or you should know how to access this particular information. It says you have to go to Manupatra, you have to go to AIR, you have to go to Westlaws, you have to go online things. The way you can access the best of law, you should try and research and put the best law forward, and then will come the drafting skills. And the client counseling, the very fundamental thing which you need to do is the client counseling. What's your body language? How you can inspire and how you can instill confidence in your client that don't worry, I'll argue out your case is on merit. Even if it lacks merit, I'll try to put merit to it by putting additional Supreme Court, you know, judgments and other things, High Court judgments and so on and so forth. So it matters how you put things. And that's called court craft. Half winning the judge is half winning the case. If you courteously appear in the court, remember all those advocates who raise their voice in the court, they are discredited. They don't earn the brownie points. Oh, he's shouting at the top of his voice. No, those are not heard. The judge doesn't want to hear that. The judge wants to hear the relevant law. Judges not interested in simple arguments, hollow arguments. Judges are more interested in getting the content of law as to what law are you quoting. And then reference to the context as to this, it really relates to this particular case or not. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'll just request you, please remain indulgent. Remain indulgent, attentive, and I wish each one of you that when you go out of this college, you should hoist VIPS flag high and say, I'm a VIPSian, I not only passed out law, but I also learned how to be good citizens. How to be good citizens? We litter the roads. We spit anywhere that we want to, urinate in open. What a shame there on this country. When you go to Singapore or any other foreign country, you behave like a gentleman or a lady. When you are in your own country, you damn with this country. Please be responsible citizens of this country. Make this country feel proud of you and your knowledge. Now there is a KP also. It's called knowledge, legal knowledge process, you know, LPOs now. Earlier it was only, now LPOs, KPOs, now KPs also have come. LPOs also have come, the legal knowledge processed. You need to be very contemporary. You cannot be quoting a law which has become obsolete now. US laws you should know, British laws you should know. If you want to be practicing abroad, you should know very well words, because Harish Salve argued India's case in the International Court of Justice. For whom? Tell me, what is his name? What was his client's name? Hey, just come here. Which Yadav? Come here. Kulbhushan Yadav. That's the right name, Kulbhushan Yadav. And what charges, what frivolous charges have been imposed against him? And look at how beautifully, I mean, in spite of the fact that Pakistan also was represented by a senior lawyer in the Supreme Court, but Harish Salve's study of the international law, international conventions, most of the conventions are drafted where? Can you tell me a country where most of the conventions are drafted? Most of the international laws are drafted? Geneva, you said, yes, that's right, Geneva. And there are only two languages, either German or French, where you cannot have a different interpretation. So you need to be well versed with French and German language, because most of the international treaties are drafted in those foreign languages. If you want to be well conversant with the international laws and international treaties which exist between nation to nation, then you need to study different languages. I want to wish you all luck, and I want to assure you our faculty is the most talented faculty. They are a very gifted people, and they have gone through their doctoral research, their masters, their net qualification from the University Grant Commission. They are recognized teachers, and it really makes me feel proud that VIPS has so far the best law faculty. And that's why we attract the best of talent. In Delhi Judicial Service, I think we should have around approximately 20 judges who are presiding, or they are VIPSians, you know, they belong to your community. And you 28 of them in total, Haryana Judiciary, Himachal Judiciary, Gujarat Judiciary, even Punjab Judiciary. Everywhere you'll find a VIPS, and where you can go and say, I too belong to VIPS, and you'll find a wonderful bonding there. You'll get a good hospitality. Himachal, I can assure you, because madam had been there to Dharamshala. If you want to go for a picnic or a holiday, you can always enjoy his hospitality. One of our boys is there. So what a joy it is, you know. People joining judiciary, people joining army, people joining the Supreme Court as advocate on record. This is what I expect from each one of you. And people sitting in the last back benchers also, I want them to be front benchers, because one day they'll have to argue independently without having to have juniors. You'll be yourself juniors there. So learn the etiquettes, how to work with your seniors. If you are not going to put, they'll say, it doesn't matter, he's a casual person. The job also will become casual. Don't take law casually. It's a very serious thing. And the present country's, you know, scenario, law is becoming each day relevant. And I'm reminded of a very famous quote by Professor Madhav Menon. How many of you know about Professor Madhav Menon? Professor Madhav Menon, one lady only knows, one gentleman also knows. But there should be many, you see, because he was the pioneer of 5 years law. The entire law, why should it be in 5 years? Why it shouldn't be in 3 years after graduation? He changed the entire, there was a paradigm shift in legal education, where Justice Madhav Menon said, no, law should be understood in the background of our customs, in the background of our history, in the background of our political setup, establishment, and law needs to be taught from this perspective. And there was introduced a 5 years law. That's why you are pursuing 5 years law, integrated law. So you become an integrated whole. He said, Professor Madhavan said, a legendary figure, he said, as a legal luminary and interpreter of law, he said, law governs human conduct from the cradle to the crematorium. Remember now, law governs human conduct. Your lives and my life is all being governed by law. Right from breathing in, inhaling and exhaling, it is being controlled by law. How it matters? If you are inhaling polluted, air, immediately the Supreme Court or the lawmakers, they take cognizance of it. They say, this so many parts per million of particles, suspended particles can remain in the air. So even the environmental pollution is being controlled by a certain authority. There's a whole lot of green tribunal in this country. Green courts are there. So your air is also being protected and safeguarded by law. So from cradle to the crematorium, no, not even this. Law has gone far beyond. Even the rights of fetal have been recognized in the womb. Human dignity. You cannot play with it once you have conceived. And remember this, it's only the Indian constitution which provides right to food, right to education, and fundamental rights. I mean, the scope has been so expanded by the Supreme Court of India, different interpretation of Article 21. So all this is happening, it's a dynamic, law is very dynamic, law keeps changing. And law takes care of the times that you are passing through. Tomorrow a nuclear holocaust takes place. What compensation should be paid? A train accident takes place. Who is going to claim? How much? You need to have that quantum of punishment incorporated into it. There's a train accident, it's taken very lightly under the Indian Railways Act. Whereas a bus accident or a car accident is taken, viewed very seriously. BMWs have been meeting many accidents, committing many accidents. BMWs are supposedly the rich man's pride, So rich man's pride is taken care of by giving them punitive action. They take punitive action against them. So law embraces all facets of human life, and you are studying such an important subject that you can do a great deal of good to yourself, to your family, to the society, to the country as a whole. Harish Salve, I want to make one of you to come and reach that level of Harish Salve, who charges 1 crore for an appearance. Many times, depending on corporate houses, because he is known as a corporate lawyer, very favorite lawyer, they want favors. If the Reliance wants favors, they'll always engage Harish Salve. If the ZTV people wants Harish Salve, why? Because he knows the law back to back. He knows all about the law and how to interpret the law and how to make a presentation before the apex court. Now we made India proud in the International Court of Justice, and Kulbhushan Yadav's case has been so well argued that Pakistan has been cornered completely, has been completely marginalized, and it's India's moral victory over that wicked country which is promoting terrorism in this country. So ladies and gentlemen, I'll not take much of your time because I know each one of you have left homes early morning, and then you would have found problem in parking your cars, and then coming down to your classroom is also a very painful task now. So thank you very much for having to attend all the classes, for having to park your car, for having to travel all the way from your homes to the institute. I thank you for all this. Thank you. And remember, what I told you is always stay in form. In best of form you are, the greater you are respected. Your self-esteem will never get hurt if you really go and be honest with yourself. First thing is respect has to come. You should be a respected lawyer. You should command respect in this society. You want to contest in bar council election or a bar association election. You want to be leader of the lawyer community, even then you need to be very well qualified. You need to be better than the rest, because you are competing all the while. You are competing with your, with the rest of your peers, or with the rest of your, of this crowd of millions of lawyers on the road. You need to be one up. So I wish you all the best. Thank you. And God bless you. God bless you all.